Time for destructive testing is finally here. In today's video, we'll be showing the results from the testing of our first 7 set of samples. The purpose of our testing is to compare the strength of different mixes of aircrete and different reinforcements in aircrete relativistically with each other and against a standard aircrete mixture. Our standard aircrete mixture is 5 gallons of water to 94 pounds of Portland cement, then filled with foam to a volume of 45 gallons or 6 cubic feet. Our first test is a drop test where I drop a weight in a controlled manner from a controlled height and measure the impact that it makes on the aircrete sample block. This is a way to relativistically test compression strength and compare it between the different blocks. We can see how far in the rod goes into the material and then compare that distance throughout the samples. We'll be doing the drop test on the front and back of the block to see if there's any difference, any settlement within the block. And then we'll also be testing with a bigger bar on the corner, and that'll kind of simulate an impact test or a strike test to see if there's any fracturing or chipping. Here you can see our testing on our standard mix batch, and we just did the drop test on the back here. So the numbers that we got there on the top was we had a depth of 0.63 inches or 16 millimeters. And on the back, we had a depth of 0.68 inches or 17.3 millimeters. So it actually went in just a little bit deeper on the back than on the front, but not significantly, which is a little counterintuitive. I would have thought it would have been in deeper on the back than on the front. And here's the corner testing on the standard sample. We use a bigger bar for this and drop it from the same height. As you can see, it broke the corner out. And that's because I was a little close to the corner. I'm trying to stay within a half an inch to 3/4 of an inch from the corner. So we tested it again and got the alignment a little better. And this time it didn't break out the corner. The next part of the testing is a tensile strength test. And we test that strength by just basically suspending this bar between two blocks and then adding weight until it tears apart. And that's why it's a tensile strength test. Each bar is 4 inches by 4.5 inches by 36 inches long, and the span between the blocks is 29 inches. And I'm using about a 5.5 inch wide board here to set the weights on, which I, of course, center between the span. When we were in the process of perfecting our method for making these aircrete samples, we did capture a couple samples of kind of imperfect mixes, and those came in handy here as we were trying to kind of calibrate how much weight, you know, these bars could take, because I had no idea how much strength they might have, you know, and how much weight it might take them to break. And I didn't want to just start adding huge bricks one after the other, because then you don't get any granularity in, you know, exactly how much weight were they able to hold. And so we had several of these test bricks from kind of failed batches that we were able to use to get a good idea of how much the standard mix bar might hold, and kind of get closer, get to a good starting point so that we wouldn't start with too much weight. And here I am dialing in, just trying to figure the order in which to add weights. Also, we have different blocks that are different weights, and just trying to figure out all that so we get good results when we start actually using our samples. Here, I just started out with one of the big bricks, and I think these bricks are around 22, 23 pounds, and then just started adding these small weights that I had. The bigger ones are 5 pounds and the smaller ones are 2.5 pounds. And I kind of ran out of those. And so then I had to take those off and add a brick and then start stacking those on again. And so that's the kind of process that I wanted to avoid if possible, you know, when we're actually testing our test samples, so that we don't have the weight on the test sample for any longer than necessary, or at least the amount of weight, the amount of time that the weight is on the test sample is kind of equivalent for all of the test samples, so that's kind of moderated. The first unofficial sample that we tested held 34 pounds or 15.4 kilograms, and this particular sample here, which was also unofficial, held 57.7 pounds or 26.2 kilograms. Also, I always take off the last weight that I added, whatever weight it was that made it break. I take that weight off and don't count it in the results. And here we are getting to our first official test sample. This is, of course, the standard mix, the baseline for all the other tests. And so I'm adding weight here. I had a couple kind of big heavy bricks and then started with the smaller weights. And then I ended up having to do a little swap out when I realized that it was holding more than I expected. So I took those weights back off and went back to bricks. And eventually, I think we got a good measurement on this. I think it, which I really wanted, it was critical, especially on the standard mix, since this is kind of the baseline, that we get a really tight measurement. And this actually worked out really well. I put on a couple of those small bricks and then went back to the weights. And then when it did break, I was using the 2.5 pound weight. So I got a nice tight measurement on this one. I think the standard mix performed very well. It ended up holding 70.5 pounds or 32 kilograms, which was more than I expected. Really quite an impressive amount of weight for such a small beam spanning 24 inches. In fact, we had to end up stealing some more blocks from the steps to the connexes in order to test the next batch. Here we move into testing our low water mixture, which had 4 gallons of water to 94 pounds of Portland cement. The front test did okay. It was 0.7 inches deep or 17.8 millimeters deep. Actually not near as good as the standard mix, surprisingly. The back also didn't perform as well. It was 0.56 inches deep or 14.2 millimeters deep. Actually performed a little better than the standard mix on the back. That's strange. This batch did settle some, and so I want to put a big asterisk by this batch. It's one of two batches that we consider unsuccessful. Not that we did them wrong, but that they just didn't work out very well. And now we're moving on to our low foam mix. So for this mix, we stopped adding foam at about 80% of the normal volume. We were really impressed at how this mixture turned out overall. Seemed to be very strong. This first impact test, kind of compression test in the middle, it went 0.33 inches deep or 8.4 millimeters deep, which is much less, almost half the depth of the standard mixture. So very impressed so far, just by kind of not adding as much foam, it seems to have created a much stronger product. For the back impact test, we had a depth of 0.46 inches or 11.7 millimeters. That's still quite a bit better than the standard mix, but it's not as good as the front of the same block. And the reason we attribute this to is the wetness of the block. So we're testing these blocks wet. We just pulled them right out of the tarp and we're testing them wet. And what that does is it decreases the compressive strength and slightly increases the tensile strength. And so since the bottom of the block is wetter, that may be why it's going in deeper on the bottom of the block. Now we're going into the tensile strength testing for the low water mix. So going back a batch to the low water. And we expected this to be pretty strong, even though this was a fouled mix and I had to kind of add more foam after it had already sunk. But it didn't do nearly as well as we thought. As you can see here, it breaks when I put on that third big brick. Just as soon as I let it, the weight go from my fingers, it immediately broke. This mixture held 47.8 pounds or 21.7 kilograms. And here we are moving on to the low foam mixture test. We'll see how much it holds. Remember, the last mixture held only two of the large bricks. This one just keeps going. April had to really lean back to get it all in the shot. And about here, we're beginning to wonder if we have enough bricks ready. So the low foam mixture held an amazing 113.6 pounds or 51.5 kilograms. So here, just for fun, we decided to see what would happen if we dropped the bar on just like a standard cement paver. Just for information's sake, the small bar weighs 2.85 pounds or 1.29 kilograms, and the large bar that we're using for the corner drop weighs 4.26 pounds or 1.93 kilograms, and both are dropped from a height of 4 feet 3 or 4 inches or 1.3 meters. And here we're moving on to the drop tests for our sand mixes. Now the first one we'll be looking at here has a 1/2 to 1 sand ratio, so 1/2 to 1 sand to 1 part cement by weight. The top impact tested at 0.56 inches or 14.2 millimeters, which is a little better than the standard mix, but not as good as, say, the low foam mix. The back impact tested at 0.69 inches or 17.5 millimeters, which is actually a little worse than the standard mix, not nearly as good as the low foam mix. When we did the corner impact test, it did blow out the edge on this one, and like I say, it's a little bit hard to get my rig lined up perfectly, and I think I was a little close to the edge on this one, so we tried it again on another corner, and it didn't blow out the edge on this one. We're also checking the depth that we get from these corner impact tests, and we'll have that in the spreadsheet that'll be available. The block we're testing now is our 1-to-1 sand mix, so one ratio of 1-to-1 sand to concrete by weight. The top test was a depth of 0.3 inches or 7.6 millimeters, which was the best yet. I should mention that this sample dropped considerably, like 25%, so we don't consider it a successful mix, but we decided to test it anyway, just see what it would do. The back depth tested at 0.28 inches or 7.1 millimeters, the best yet, and the corner did fine too with a very low compression. And now we're moving on to the tensile strength testing for the 1/2 to 1 sand mix. This batch ended up surprising us in how weak it was in the tensile strength test, and so as a consequence, I didn't get my brick stacking correct, and I ended up putting too many big bricks on and breaking it and not getting good granularity. Now we're moving on to the full 1-to-1 sand mixture. We just keep stacking on this one. It's holding way more than we expected. Too bad it had sunk 25% and isn't really a viable option. It ended up holding a substantial 104 pounds or 47.2 kilograms. Substantial, but still is not as good as the low foam mix. Here we are redoing the test on the 1/2 to 1 sand mix. Since we didn't get good granularity the first time, fortunately we had an extra sample that we could test here. This time we only went with a few bricks and then started to go to the smaller weights. This time it held 61.4 pounds or 27.9 kilograms, a little bit less than our standard mix. In our next video, we'll finish up testing the rest of the samples, and then we'll summarize and discuss the rest of the results. We also have all of this captured on a spreadsheet, and we'll be sharing that data with the next video.